Hello everyone. So in today's lecture, we're going to do some of the applications of partial derivatives in economics. And let's begin. First example is, consider an agricultural production function where Y is output. And output is a function of K capital, L labor, and T agricultural land that is used. Okay. So obviously, if you take a partial derivative of Y, with respect to k, that is del y upon del k, is going to be perceived as f dash k is nothing but change in output due to a slight or additional unit of change in capital input. And that is nothing but the marginal product of capital. So, is the rate of change of output y with respect to k when l and t as inputs and as variables are held fixed? Likewise, you can interpret del y upon del l and del y upon del t, which are marginal products of labor and land respectively. Now, so you have in particular f as a Cobb-Douglas production function, a, k to the power small a, l to the power small b, t to the power small c, and you're asked to find out marginal products and second order partials. Second order partial means you have to find the cross partials and own partials both. What I'm trying to say is, once you have found out f dash k, you need to find out f double dash kk and also f double dash kl and kt. Okay, let's see how we're going to go about this. Firstly, let's try to find out the marginal products. Marginal product is the derivative of my output function or production function with respect to the input in question. So f dash k would be a, k to the power a derivatives to a, k to the power a minus 1, l to the power b and t to the power c would stay constant since they are treated as constant while you are partially derivating it with respect to k. Similarly, you can find out f dash l and f dash t. Now, assuming that k, l and t are all positive, you can easily see that all your marginal products will be positive. Okay, so you can test for yourself taking some values of a and b, so likewise. And now let's try finding out the second order partials. Firstly, the cross partials, and then we'll find out the own partials, and then we'll try to interpret them. F double dash kl, I'm not doing the derivative part, it's quite easy, will be coming out to be this. Likewise, f double dash kt. So if you want that, I'll do it for you. F double dash kl. That means you derivate f dash k with respect to l. So that will be, everything will remain constant except l to the power b will get derivated to b into l to the power b minus 1. So that is something you're going to arrive at right in front of you. Okay, so it's quite easy to go around it, and using Young's theorem, f double dash kl is going to be the same as f double dash lk. Likewise, l kt will be equal to tk and lt will be equivalent to tl. Now the question arises of interpreting this particular part. We already noticed that f dash k is positive, likewise f dash l and f dash t all came out to be positive for given values of a, b and c. That means marginal products of each of the inputs are coming out to be positive. That means each input contributes positively to the output. That's understood. Now, f double dash kk, f double dash kl means, let's try to interpret it, f double dash kl, it refers to the change in marginal product of capital as labor input is increased, keeping land input and capital input constant. Okay, so what happens to the marginal product of capital as you employ more labor in your production? So you can easily see that all these partial derivatives also are going to come out to be positive, as they say that. You can check it for yourself, and these will all come out to be positive. And these cross partial derivative being positive would mean that both the inputs in either combinations are complementary in nature. That means if you increase the quantity of one of the inputs, that actually enhances the marginal product of the another input. That means the factors are complementary to each other in pairs and they tend to enhance the productivity when employed in good combinations. Okay, so that was about the cross partials. Now, let's look at the own partials, that is KK, LL and TT. Likewise, you can derivate F dash K with respect to K and you will have this, and F dash L with respect to L and you shall have this. Now, let's try to look at their sign. Now, see, whenever A is going to be less than 1, your F double dash KK will come out to be negative. Likewise, for B and C also less than 1, F double dash LL and F double dash TT will also come out to be negative. What does that mean? That means that if F double dash KK, F double dash LL and F double dash TT are negative, that means the marginal product, are you understanding? The marginal product of the relevant input actually decreases with increase in the input employed. That means F double dash KK refers to change in marginal product of capital as more of capital is employed in the production. And if this is negative, that would mean that there are diminishing returns to the capital stock. And the interpretation is also written here, that if F double dash KK is negative, that is less than 0, then there are diminishing marginal product of capital, that is small increase in capital invested will lead to a decrease in the marginal product of capital. But we read here before this that marginal product came out to be positive. That is F dash K, F dash L and F dash T, they were all positive. But their own partial derivatives are negative. That means although the output increases, that is marginal product of all the inputs are positive, but output tends to increase at a decreasing rate since the marginal products tend to decrease with increase in their employment in production and they will try to reduce the increase in the output. Okay, so that's the classic production function which we study in microeconomics, and I'll try to draw it for just one of the inputs. Let's say this is L, this is your output Y, and that's how we draw our production function. So initially output increases at an increasing rate, then it increases at a decreasing rate, and ultimately it falls. So, if you are given a production function in microeconomics and you need to explain whether there are diminishing returns to inputs, what do you need to prove? You need to prove that own partial derivative is negative. Fine. Let's move on to the second application. It's quite interesting. Let X be the index of total amount of goods produced and consumed in the society. And let Z be a measure of the level of pollution. Okay. And both the amount of goods and the level of pollution enter the utility function of the society and becomes UXZ. So UXZ measures the total well-being of the society, and the question says, what signs do you expect for U-X, U-Z, and can you guess what the economists usually assume about the sign of U-XZ? We'll go to the basics. What does U-X means? Okay, now U dash X means change in total utility as the goods produced and consumed by the society increase by a unit. And this particular utility is expected to be positive because goods do good to the people. Everyone likes to consume goods. Obviously, marginal utility will also increase at a diminishing rate. That's diminishing marginal utility. So if you find out U double dash XX, that should come out to be negative. That means diminishing marginal utility. However, the question hasn't asked you as of now. So U dash X clearly would be positive. And what about U dash Z? Now ask yourself, as a society member, does level of pollution do good to you? No. So what you would expect, that change in total utility with increase in the level of pollution should be negative. The pollution does not do good to the society as a whole. Now what can we say about the sign of U-XZ? What does this mean? This means you try to partially derivate U dash X with respect to Z. That means the rate at which the rate of change in marginal utility due to an increased consumption and production of good X with a slight increase in pollution levels. Okay, so it's actually, as written here, U-XZ is approximately equal to the change in U dash X, that is marginal utility due to X, when the level of pollution increases by a unit. Okay, now you only ask yourself, if you're staying, let's say you're sharing a room with your friend, and that friend likes to smoke, and if your friend likes to smoke and at the same time you want to study in that room also because you have to, what is going to happen next? Your utility because of studying in the presence of your friend smoking is going to be negative. However, if the friend was not present, and if he was present, but he was not smoking at that moment, your utility would be increasing. Okay, so that was just one example that in the presence of increasing levels of pollution, okay, that is increasing levels of smoke concentration in the room where you're trying to study, will affect your utility from studying. And then let's proceed to the second part of economic applications. You can try doing this example and this example on your own. These are from Hammond only. We're doing chapter 15 from Hammond. Now let's come on to the part of linear models with quadratic objectives. And it has two cases. I will be exploring both of these cases in the next video. Thank you for watching the video.